Hi, my name is Adam. I'm one of the co-directors and co-founders of BetaJester Limited. I am a programmer, but I'm also sort of a frontman, PR man, speaker, developer, and a whole bunch of different things in between.
So if we're talking about technical skills for different roles in the games industry, especially like at the stage where you're starting to move from education and look for your first job, whether that be from A-levels or university, wherever it may be, the key things to be looking for are what skills do you need to demonstrate your capabilities? And that changes depending on what kind of area you're looking into. So if you're a programmer, being able to demonstrate your capacity to build interesting, you know, mechanics and those kind of things, to be able to execute on them, is more important than any particular way of demonstrating it. So for example, as a programmer, you might want to learn Unity or Unreal or Godot or GameMaker, all these different kind of engines, or do it yourself with something like Monogame or Python or all those kind of things. The key here is demonstrating that you are able to use your skills and apply them to building something that can then be used in a game. Because different games companies will all use different engines. You know, you could apply to a Unity-specific studio with, if you applied with Unreal knowledge, then they'll want to know if you're able to port it. And it may be that it may work against you, and that if you apply to somewhere that's Unity-specific with Unreal knowledge, they go, we don't have the time to train you in this. However, you can still demonstrate your capabilities, and especially for junior positions, they're more about understanding your passion and understanding your general capability than they are any particular skill. When you start to get into more formalized positions, you know, roles, seniors, all those kind of things, then they're going to start to want to see experience in certain types of technologies. But all the kind of jobs you apply for will state, you know, oh, we're looking for, you know, 3 years with Unity experience or 2 years with Pygame or whatever it might be. This is also true, it's less true in other positions. Programming is a specific thing because of the use of engines. In other places, it will be more about your technical proficiency to demonstrate that you're capable of doing whatever it is they need. So as a UI designer, having a good knowledge of any UI program, so you know whether that's gonna be something like Adobe XD or whether it's gonna be something like Lunacy or whatever it might be, and being able to demonstrate your output, going, here are some UI designs that I've made for, you know, for an RPG, so they're a bit more creative and arty, for a mobile app, so they're a bit more clean and minimalist. Being able to show off your technical skill matters more than the technology you use to develop it, because generally speaking, they all export to formats that you can be used in any kind of game engine or whatever it may be. So for a lot of roles, it's more about knowing a technology and knowing it well enough to demonstrate that you understand the fundamentals and the concepts and the things that apply to different games companies than it is any particular one, maybe apart from programming just because it's so specific. But even then, if you understand languages at a core level, then those apply in different places. What I would say is, what another good thing to know about are tools and being aware of different tools that sort of sit around games in sort of the production level, because the more easily you can integrate into a company's pipeline and how they run their company, the more likely they are to hire you because you fit their kind of remit. So these are tools like Trello, which is like a list and cards tool. Jira, you have to pay for, but if you ever get an opportunity to learn about that, definitely take it, because that's used by lots of games companies. All the standards as well, things like Slack, Discord, probably familiar with already. But games companies use these kind of communication and team working tools to help keep everyone in line with each other, know who's doing what, etc. So the more you know about those as well, the more you'll look like somebody who understands the business, who understands games, and is ready to work in a team. If you're coming from another area, a degree that isn't games, or a subject matter that isn't games, and you're interested in sort of getting into games, the key here is to look at your transferable skills. So there are some very kind of low level skills that just need to be learned. So for example, programming, unless you've done a course that particularly had programming, of which there's really only like physics and maths do a little bit of programming here and there, that, or maybe software engineering, but that's sort of very similar. Then you would have to go away and learn the fundamentals. But other areas, so places particularly that are more abstracted, like production, marketing, community management, these kind of areas, they rely on more generalized skills that generally can be learned in other areas. So to give an example, I have a friend who did chemistry at university, and he went and worked in a chemical company. But while there, he did a lot of team management, leadership roles. He learned about how to get a team working together, how to check everybody was on time, how to work with them to understand their issues and problems, which are the exact same skill set as a producer in the games industry. Somebody who helps manage a team, helps the production of the game by making sure everybody's on task and those kind of things. And he moved from that chemical company to a games company as a junior producer, or I think it was project lead or something. But with that skill set, those transferable skills that said, I understand this role because I've done a similar thing in another industry. So the key here is looking at what is it from your current role, course, whatever, that can be applied to the games industry. And if it's not your role, what is it from your life or your experience? You know, lots of people have had management experience in loads of jobs. You know, becoming, if you're a team leader in any form, whether it's, you know, working in a bar or a restaurant, those kind of skills can apply to places like production or management or leadership or any of those kind of community management, for example. So it's really about trying to abstract and think about what skills can be transferred from what you're doing to the games industry and more generally, you know, any kind of business. In terms of moving to like from your course to a master's, the key there is what is it that you, where in the games industry do you want to land, and does your course kind of lean into it? So if you've done something that involves programming, then yes, it's going to be fine. But if you've done something more like, let's say, geography, there's probably less transferable skills over moving into like a master's. Outside of, you know, so it's more about, okay, well, where do I want to land and how do I sort of build that up? So I definitely look at the requirements for courses and master's degrees and that kind of thing, and figure out how you get those skills, whether you can transfer them from your existing course or whether it's something you need to go and learn outside, have some experience of before you apply for it.